Now see, let's do understand what is corporate social responsibility. See, in India, the government has made certain norms in terms of corporate social responsibility. Now what is that? Let's understand. In Companies Act 2013, it was mentioned that the companies are required to allocate certain percentage of their profit for CSR activities, that is corporate social responsibility activities. Okay, now who are those companies who are supposed to do that? So see, this was mandatory for some categories. What were those companies? A company having a net worth of 500 crores, or if a company has a turnover of 1000 crores, or if a company has a net profit of 5 crores. Okay, so if any of the companies fell in above categories, then they were required to apportion 2% of the average profit which they have earned in the past 3 years to activities which are related to social cause. Okay, so what you have to do is you have to see first if the company falls in any of these criteria or not, that is categories or not. If yes, then CSR is mandatory for them. Then you have to calculate the net profit they have earned in the last 3 years. You need to average it and calculate the 2% amount of that. Once you have calculated that, you need to ensure that that amount is being used for social cause, and you need to maintain records for the same. Now let us see few corporate houses who have implemented various corporate programs under CSR. Okay, the first is Mahindra and Mahindra. This is a company which produces tractors. It is famous for its tractors. Now they started this program Nanni Kali, which was nothing but focusing on the girl child education. Okay, now Mahindra Pride School was also one thing which they started, which basically helps in giving industrial training to low income group people. Okay, they also have this Lifeline Express, which is a kind of health services for remote areas. So the CSR activity which has been taken by M&M is three activities, which is first the Nanni Kali, second this Pride School for industrial training, and lastly this Lifeline Express for healthcare services. The next is ITC. Now they came up with the CSR activity of creating e-Chopal program. What was that? It aimed to connect the rural farmers through the internet, and for the reason for collecting them or bringing them together was to ensure they are procuring agriculture goods which covers 40,000 villages and over 4 million farmers. Okay, so basically they were getting the goods through internet on a cheaper price because e-Chopal bought them on a same platform. They bought the buyer and the seller on the same platform. Now lastly, when it comes to 2015 and 16, there has been a 28% growth in the CSR spending compared to the previous year. So remember, with the introduction of the CSR activity, the companies who have the capability and who are coming under this criteria, they have started following various innovative ways to ensure the growth and the development of the villages. This brings us to the end of the video.